I'm with Nicolas Pereira, who is the PPC candidate in St. John Rothsay here in New Brunswick. We're at a meet and greet with Maxime Bernier and a few people just starting to turn out here for a 12 o'clock event. And Nicolas is here and kindly agreed to an interview to let us here at Just Right Media let his people know a little bit about him. So Nicolas, why the PPC?
Yeah, that's a great question, because actually when I was going to run, I was going to run independent. So I decided I want to get involved because I didn't like where our country was going. My background, I spent the last decade as a personal passion studying different cultures and philosophies. And so I have some knowledge of Marxist and communist philosophy. And what I started to see in our country under the disguise of a pandemic was this Marxist philosophy being used. And we're not, you know, I'm not anti-vaccine or I don't deny COVID or anything like this, but I do question that that if COVID was not used as a political tool to push this Marxist philosophy forward. And so what Marxist philosophy looks like is state owns everything, government owns everything, and we as the people, we work and we do everything for the state. And in those type of states, individual rights gets lost. So I started speaking against this. I created a Facebook page like most of us do when we start to be keyboard warriors, right, in this age. And I started to get some traction and people say, yes, thank you for saying this. And then I was introduced to the People's Party of Canada. I read all the platforms of every party. I definitely align with the PPC. I believe in freedom of choice, fairness, personal responsibility. And so I decided Max is the man and I'm getting behind this and we're gonna fight for freedom in this country.
If there was a single issue in Canada or even here locally in New Brunswick, what would it be for you?
Looking at immigration reform, I'm an immigrant myself. My family was denied in 1987. We reapplied and came in 1988. Because at that point, Canada had a quota of about 150,000. And we at the PPC want to bring it back to that. Justin Trudeau has an open door policy of 400,000 people coming into this country. And he wants to continuously increase that. Now, this is not refugees and this is not humanitarian work. They try to fuse those two topics together. What we're talking about is an open door policy where people can come into this country, and Justin Trudeau is telling everybody that we are a post-national state, which means we don't have a Canadian identity. That's what he's going around and telling the country, the world, excuse me. And that is not true. It's a very dangerous rhetoric, because what it does is as these folks come into the country, like my family did, instead of integrating, like my family did, and becoming part of the Canadian society and taking on Canadian identity, he's telling them, come on in, but you don't have to learn the language. You don't have to contribute. You don't have to do it. You can just bring yourself here, and we're a post-national state. And to me, this is a very dangerous topic that I'm speaking against.
Anything for the St. John Rothsay electorate that you may want to speak to? Any particular issue in that area that catches your attention?
You know what? Quite honestly, we're treating the country fairly right across the board, right? So we don't have policies special for St. John. To Vancouver or to anyone else. So I'll tell anybody across the country, this is federal, so we're dealing with national issues, and personal responsibility needs to be taken all over the country. And I will tell St. John Rothsay that if somebody really cares about you, they tell you sometimes unpalatable or uncomfortable truths because they genuinely want to help you. But if they don't want to help you, they're just going to tell you what you want to hear. The Liberals, the Conservatives, the Uni Party, right, with the Green and the NDP, they're all the same, and they're all telling everybody what they want to hear. But I really want to help people, as people have helped me in my life to grow and become better, and they did that by telling me the honest truth of where I needed to make some new decisions. And that's what I want to do for St. John Rothsay Riding and Canadians all across the board. It's like, let's get to real conversations and stop playing politics, and let's talk about improving our lives and our communities.
A great answer, and unexpected, really, because if I asked that to somebody from any of the other parties, and then I asked them specifically about their ratings. Oh, I will work for the brewery. I'll work for your shipyard. You know, I'll get a grant for this other business down there and work for the people of St. John Rothsay that way. But it's refreshing to hear a candidate actually saying, I'm going to work for everything. And that's basically Maxime's message as well. What do you think of Maxime? He's here now.
You know what? It's funny because, like I said, I joined the party. I wasn't, like most people, politics was like, meh. I was always had interest in philosophy, but politics, I was like, no. But again, when everything started happening, I started to see the Marxist type and communist type socialist philosophy starting to take hold in our country. It's like, we have to fight this. This is going to be bad for everyone. And then that's when I saw the platform, and then I got introduced to Maxim. And it all made sense. Maxim, I looked, Maxim for 10 years has been saying this message. He has been steady for 10 years. You know, that's why he got the name Mad Max, right? Because even in the Harper government, he was around saying this message, and he stuck to his principles. And I can get behind a man who sticks to his principles, even if they're not popular. Because eventually people will wake up, and this is the voice of the people. It's just right now we're being overrun by a corrupt media who tries to do nothing for us. Like, they don't give us time. They try to blacklist us, suppress us. And that just means we have a message that they really don't want people to hear. But it's clear, you know, here in Sussex, St. John, Ross, all across the country, people are coming to hear this message. So I stand behind Max. And now that I've got to spend time with him, he's a man of his principles.
Nicholas Pereira, thank you very much.
Thank you. I appreciate it.